Hello, today we are solving one of the most common problems in blockchain, especially in Ethereum, which is a re-entrancy problem. So jumping immediately into the smart contract, we can see that it's a very simple donate and withdraw pattern. So nothing interesting in donate balance of functions. Also, we can see that we use SafeMath, so it's probably not about under or overflows. So the only important function here is the withdraw. And here, if you are proficient in re-entrancy problems, you can see that we start sending money to the message sender wallet before taking the money from his balance mapping. And of course, it's a problem because then we can, if we use a smart contract, and a smart contract is the message sender, he can loop through the withdrawal and trigger all of the money withdrawals even before triggering the last lines of code, which take the money away from our balance. So we'll basically drain the whole smart contract. And we have our contracts in Remix. So we have the re-entrancy one, which is like an interface to what we have on Ethernaut, but for the implementation. And we have our re-entrancy attack with attack function, which indeed attacks the smart contract. So we will first donate the money, then we will withdraw the money. And when the money is being withdrawn, the victim will send money to the re-entrancy attack smart contract. So it will trigger the receive function. And in the receive function, we will check whether the contract has more money that's than it sends us. And if it has, then we will say that we want to withdraw again. So it will make it so that instead of right here, instead of going to the next lines, it will jump to the line one again, and it will loop through those two lines forever until it drains all of the money. So last part is checking how much money we have in the smart contract, so that we know how much money we can drain per iteration in the loop. So to do that, we check the balance. We see the balance, and we can convert it to Ether. Oh, here it is. So if we want to drain it in 10 iterations, we'll use 1/10 of it in our smart contract. So it's this much in way. And knowing that and having this plan, let's jump to the execution part.
Okay, so for the execution part, we need to deploy our contract. So first of all, we need to get the implementation address. We'll find it on Ethernaut, where we can get the new instance. We already did, so we can only copy that. Okay, great. So now we can also check here the balance, because as Jacob mentioned, we got the function for that. So we can call it contract instantly. And our goal is to perform the function attack, donate, and then we'll withdraw the funds. So let's call the function. We have to first set the value for that. So we'll get that amount, and we'll get 1/10 that. So now we have to check if we got enough gas limit, because there will be like 11 transactions, 1/10 of the wall withdraw amount, which we have in the contract. So we have to make sure that the gas limit is enough. Change that because it's a little less. So now we can confirm that. And we can check if it's right. If the balance will be empty, means that went through. All right. So now we can go back to the turnout and confirm that. Yes. All right, great. So we've done it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Like, subscribe, and see you.